Would it be a sin if I can't help falling in love with you?
Hey guys, and welcome back to the Sunderland Football Manager Series episode 25, is it? I've lost count. We're almost a quarter of the way to 100, I'm guessing. But as we start every episode, this is a pre-recorded one as well, or post-recorded, we look at the league table. We sit 21st in the league, which isn't the worst, but isn't the best. But you'll notice we're out of the relegation zone, and that's because we've got a win. If you haven't seen last episode, go watch it, because we're going to be telling you what's happened off-screen and last episode. So 3, 2, 1, bang. Last episode, we drew 3 games, but this time, off screen, I have played 3 as well. In the first one, we lost 2-0 at Bramall Lane to Sheffield United. We held on really well, but they've just surged up the table after a bad start. John Fleck and Lys Mousset scoring late on against us to deflate us. And then the next game, we carried on being deflated. It was against Brentford, who were bottom of the league at this point. We travelled to the new stadium, the Brentford Community, that's replaced Griffin Park, I think. They were 2-0 up within half an hour. Gyökeres' consolation was not enough to get us anything out of the game, as we lost that one. But we did not fall after that. We won 1-0. We changed the formation, which I'll show you shortly. But Sam Smith, the player who I brought in to be a backup and even maybe ship out on loan, ended up not. Gave him a start, scored in the 8th minute, and we held on after them taking a lot of shots in the second half. We held on to get our first win, and that is a big confidence boost going into the season, as we won 1-0. And we have 3 games in this episode, so smash like if you want more of this series. We have West Brom, who are pushing for playoffs, Cardiff, who are near bottom of the league, I think the 23rd, and MK Dons at home, who came up with us last season. So that'll be a challenge, because they are actually doing better than I thought. And this is the formation we've gone to: 5 at the back, 2 in midfield, a cam, and then 2 up front. And actually, I'll show you the team that we're going to use right now, because we're going to use this. McGee is in net, Flanagan, Robson just drops back a bit more, and Kerr in the back 3, as Kerr and Flanagan link well together. Emmanuel and Townsend, although unconvincing, they are my wing backs and they play pretty well there. They just get tired sometimes. Stevens and Stewart in the midfield, the best 2 midfielders over Longcar and Embleton, which haven't been the best. Barlow is in the cam position, just in front of them, and Gyökeres is a good pressing forward, with Sam Smith as an advanced forward. He's better at that, because Gyökeres was always a bit more defensive in his role. Anyway, we start quite brightly against West Brom here. Connor Townsend scoring against his former club, flying up from that wing-back spot, but in the replay, you'll just see how good Dale Stevens puts it on a plate for him. It was a throw-in from Emmanuel, just a short one, which wasn't the best, actually. They headed it out. Dale Stevens floats a really good ball over the top for Connor Townsend to put it in. In half time, there wasn't many highlights. In fact, there was only that goal. So it was really good for us at half time. We were flying 1-0. And in the second half, as you'll see right now, there wasn't many as well. I mean, I had to include a substitution as a highlight, because there wasn't much to go off of. I put Longcar on, but no highlights is kind of a blessing in disguise, because we're not conceding. But then in the 87th minute, they put a ball over Nathan Ferguson, coming very close, and 09 clearing. It was offside in the end, and we got another back-to-back win, another 1-0 one. But 1-0 ones, as many pros will tell you, are the best kind of results, because you're just edging it. And saying that, we are just edging above relegation ever so slightly more. We are 19th now, 10 points, and we play Cardiff, who actually dropped to bottom of the league with their result. And I think they sacked the manager, which was Ralph Hasenhüttl at the time. But in the meantime, we go back to a squad. I think, what else can I do to improve this squad? Jared Henderson, who's a winger. We're obviously not playing wingers now, but we could maybe go back to it. I decided to give him an extra contract, because I like the way he plays, and I've decided to train him as a pressing forward himself, so he can go in place of Gyökeres and maybe Sam Smith when needed. So Jared Henderson accepts his contract, as I tried to, as you might have just seen, get Boha some more game time at Rochdale. But here is the squad for the game. I can't remember who's it against, but we bring Knight into the team as Tom Flanagan He's still on international duty and very tired. He's just got onto the bench. We've got him alongside Robinson, Kurt, Emmanuel, Townsend, Stevens and Stewart in the midfield with Barlow just in front of them and Gyökeres and Sam Smith just in front. And it's against Cardiff, I've just remembered, away in Wales, because this is the manager that have McGuill, Angel, Nadal. They've appointed him on a full-time basis, and I think he was only Hasenhüttl's assistant, so a bit of a risky move there from them, if you ask me. But we go into this game, start quite brightly with his tiki-taka out from the back. We've changed to tiki-taka as well. I don't think I showed you that. And we build his way upfield. Knight with a good ball over the top to Gyökeres, who just puts it wide of the mark. I know he probably should have scored there, but we're going to try the same. Knight to Robinson and to Kerr. We're playing it all around the defence in this game. Playing very, very well. Not many highlights in this first half, as you'll see. We're in the 16th minute, and this is only the second one. There's never any highlights when I record a video, but then they steal the ball off us, and they come forward with Smith. I don't know if it's Ben Smith or not, but he was a really, really good player for them in this game. Kurt on the ball now, gives it in the middle, and then it's put over the top to Sam Smith. It was a good ball, but he just hits the side netting, and I just thought, geez, if that's how we're doing it, I don't know what I can improve. And we get to half-time unscathed, 0-0. They grew into the first half and definitely grew into the second half more. We got a good break, a lucky break, as I'll say, with Gyökeres here, but he hit it straight at the keeper. I mean, put it anywhere else but there. And now they come forward in this second half to get a shot off with, I think it's Leon Bakuna. I think it's either him or his brother, who was a Huddersfield. And now they come forward with Kamara as well. Kevin Stewart giving away a penalty, and that's not what we wanted. 12 minutes to go on the clock as well. Kamara is going to step up for it against Luke McGee, and Luke McGee dives, but not as much. And they get a 1-0 lead in this game. And to top it all off, Ben Smith coming down this left-hand side, puts it in. McGee's nowhere, and Kamara doubles it to cut off all our chances of a salvaging a draw in this game. And we go ahead and lose 2-0 in Cardiff to bottom of the league. I mean, it is early days, so although the bottom of the league, there still was a really good side. We grew into it. Well, we started the better team. Most of them 15 shots actually came in the first half with about 11. But then the second half, there was absolutely all over us, and I said it were good. I regret doing that. And now they're right behind us in the league. We stay 19th with them just on 9 points, 1 point behind us. Rotherham sitting bottom of the league now. And we are in maybe a little bit of trouble. I'm not considering any big changes at the moment, as this is his next team. We've brought Flanagan in. I'm not going to really say anything, but Flanagan's in. 09 is in. And Henderson comes in up front for, what's his name now? It's Sam Smith, that's it, because he scored that one goal, then just dipped. Just didn't do anything in any games, as you saw in the last one. He just missed a pretty one-on-one shot that he should have pretty much scored. And this team that we're facing, MK Dons, Edmondson, Poole, Callum Britton, they've got some decent players. And stay tuned and buckle up for this next game, because this was an exciting one. We started the game off, we wanted to motivate the boys with this passionate talking that we always do. I say I have faith and that they can make the difference. These MK Dons are actually flying in the league, 12th position already, and we didn't cover ourselves in glory from the off. Connor Townsend scoring an own goal, a free kick whipped in. I think it was a left footer who's whipped it in. I can't believe that. 1-0 down. I mean, we should be beating Oxford that we didn't beat, and we should be beating MK Dons who came up with us. I don't know who it was who headed it across the box, but find ourselves 1-0 down, and literally seconds later on the 10-minute mark, they find themselves 2-0 up. Ronan Darcy with his second of the season, assisted by Will Ferry. That's the second set piece conceded in this game, and we're not having as luck from them this season. A good ball in. It was like Dale Stevens against West Brom in the first game. But then Connor Townsend making up for his own goal with a cross in to Jack Robinson, who's his counterpart at left back, playing in centre back. He gets his first goal of the season. Townsend maybe showing a bit of redemption for his mistake, but it's not enough yet. We're still 2-1 down, and it didn't even show you how it happened, but we gave a penalty away straight after we'd scored the highlight, literally straight after. And now we're 3-1 down. Alex Gibby at home as well. It's the Stadium of Light. And if it carries on like this, we are in real danger. And we get a corner. It comes back to Barlow. He puts a ball in near the front post, and Kevin Stewart with his first goal of the season from midfield. He needed to start contributing more, and hopefully he does after that goal. A good ball in from Barlow. It was just headed away at the first time of asking by Edmondson, our ex-Leeds player, and Stewart with an easy chance to put it in the bottom corner. And that was half-time, 3-2. A lot of goals, and there's still more to come in this second half, as I wanted to say to my players that they're capable to get us back into this game. It comes to the edge of the box with Barlow as well. This was a big move. Connor Townsend on the left-hand side. He needed to put a killer ball into the box again. It just didn't drop. But then Luke 09, the right wing-back that we've put in the team over Emmanuel, who's getting a rest. Jeez, what a goal just before the hour mark. Connor Townsend whipping a ball in. It wasn't the best of balls, but Luke 09, the way he shapes his body up to hit that on the volley was just amazing. And now they tried to recreate it as well in the 75th minute. And now we're holding on because we've got to 3-3. And in the 94th minute, we are holding on for our dear lives. They've had about, I don't know how many shots it was, but we had dominated the game for parts. But then it fell to Gibby on the end. And this guy, I can't remember his name, has a shot. Convincing for Luke McGee. And now we had a chance. We had a chance to get up the field in the last couple of minutes. Don't take your eyes off the screen because this is big. Tom Flanagan going over the top for Gyökeres. It falls to Aaron Ramsey off the bench. The youngster loses it on loan from Aston Villa and they come forward. Barlow makes a tackle. Townsend doesn't react in time. Now Max Bird with the ball. Gives it to Reagan Poole. I'm just getting psyched up even speaking about this. And they give it over here. And this, I don't know who it was, just hits it. Will Ferry. I was getting psyched up for the wrong reason because we're going to lose against MK Dons at home 4-3. What an absolute cracker of a game and a cracker of a shot. I mean, Luke 09, I'll still say, had the better strike, but this one, don't count it out. To put it in from that angle was just amazing, and we end up losing the game. I'm going to tell them aggressively it wasn't good enough because it wasn't. We should have won that game. We conceded two set pieces, a penalty, and a wonder goal. But unfortunately, guys, that marks the end of this episode. Sorry it is a voiceover. It won't be next time. Smash like if you want episode 26 in 2 days. You know you're getting it. And smash like and comment, share and subscribe if you're enjoying the series at the moment. And I will see you all in a bit. Peace.